Hello. Thank you for joining this Mendix World Customer session. My name is Hans De Visser. I'm responsible for product management at Mendix, and today I have the privilege to interview Gerrit Dekker and John Helmink from Mammoet. Mammoet is a leading global company in the heavy lifting and transportation business, and one of those iconic brands that I grew up with as a youngster. I've always admired Mammoet for their ingenuity, making very complex transportation challenges happen. Let's look at a short video what that's about.
If you ask our crews around the globe,
my name is Patrick here.
I'm Leilani.
Jan van Junior.
There's no job too small. No matter if it's here,
it's oil and gas town.
Here,
I am in Abu Dhabi.
Or here, we make it happen. The most experienced people and always the right tools for the job. We've been doing so for many years.
I've been rigging since '99.
So we might be the biggest in heavy lifting and transport. There is never a job too small.
Pretty fascinating. Gerrit, you are the CIO of Mammoet.
Yes.
No job too small. Is that the approach you're taking for IT as well?
Yes, if we look at one of our biggest challenges in the company, it's when we have to schedule, for example, a crane has to do a lifting of a roof. And on the other end, we have to put a gas factory into Siberia. So on the one end, you have the very small job. And on the other end, you have the job that takes multiple years, is a multi-million dollar job. So indeed, no job too small. We start with the very small, but we also have to be able to provide for the very big. And all that supported by IT. So indeed, no job too small.
And from an operations perspective, you're basically globally operating in 45 countries, if memory serves well.
Indeed.
So that must be a pretty tough challenge on the IT side as well, to basically organize IT around the globe for pretty demanding operators, if you like.
Yes. Indeed, we have the luck that we are once were family-owned, and it all started in the Netherlands, and it grew across the globe. So every country where we came in, we entered with our systems, with our IT. So we have the advantage that we have more or less one way of working across the whole globe, and that makes it easier. And then, of course, we have several locations in Singapore, in Abu Dhabi, and in Houston that are IT hubs that support the central IT in Schiedam here.
Okay, thank you. And John, you've been with Mammoet for the last 6 years, manager of business applications. What's your role exactly, and how do you relate to the IT strategy of Mammoet?
Yeah. Well, the thing is, as you've seen, there are many people who are working like globally, with their own specialties, with their own cultural, let's say, aspects. And for ICT, it's in that sense challenging to, on the one hand, be able to have one way of working, and on the other hand, cater towards the individual needs of the people out there. So in that sense, it's always a matter of staying in close contact with those doing the actual job and still, being able to provide that one way of working. And indeed, as ICT, you've got a major role to play there, because that's where two worlds come together. And that's where you need to find the right way of doing stuff.
Yeah, because if I look at your landscape, you're using pretty large-scale systems like your ERP system that you, I assume, operate globally. But there's also, like you said, demands from individuals. How do you deal with that? And what's the role of low-code in that kind of approach? Can you respond to that, Gerrit?
Yeah, the ERP that we have is actually quite ancient, and we're also looking at replacing it. But until we are in the stage where it's fully replaced, we still have to make do with this legacy. On the other hand, we have a modern generation who is used to apps, mobile phones, tablets.
Smartphones, yeah.
And this is indeed where low-code platforms come in, because we are, appifying our backend SAP systems in a rapid speed, getting more and more apps into the various work areas and into the various countries. And there, you can still provide one way of working, because it's all centrally developed and it's distributed across the globe. And Mendix also allows for a rapid adoption to small local customizations. So indeed, on the one end, the back end, ancient, and on the other end, the front end, Mendix, very modern looking. So most of the users don't see the old-fashioned ERP on the back end.
Bit of the best of both worlds, maybe, with your transaction processing or transaction backend processing done by an ERP system, and then the front end mostly customer facing or employee facing applications with low code in the form of Mendix.
Indeed, yes.
What triggered it? What was there a kind of a moment where you said, "Well, let's consider low code now," or did you stumble across low code? Well, I'm intrigued by what made you decide to go for it. Do you know about that, John?
Yeah. Well, we had several challenges. For example, IoT.
Yeah.
A few years back, that was still very far away. But nowadays, it was coming closer and we needed to do something with it. Then we had pretty ancient systems like Gerrit is explaining, where we needed to upgrade. And then finally, we were looking for new applications, for example, to make better or more efficient use of engineering. And so therefore, we had several, challenges we had to cover. And we wanted to stay away from individuals doing developments in very specific codes. Maybe good in first instance where something is set up, but then also the challenge of maintaining it and not being dependent. And that's really where we went out to the market, see what was available, and then low code came up. And there we really found, our way forward with Mendix.
Nice. And can you give a couple of examples of projects that you've done so far with low-code as a program and a platform?
Yeah, and there are too many, to explain here. But one particular example, and there I refer to what Gerrit was saying. Indeed, we have our old SAP, and we have, crane operators who you don't want to bother with that ancient SAP. And there we, create or use Mendix as a front end, make it very modern, and make sure that they can just focus on the job that they are doing. And we do that with the Mammoth Task application. So let's say a front end on SAP, where we do the planning and all the financial administration in SAP, and have Mendix bring, the most essential information to the operator, let him work with it, and when he finishes his or her job, just put a signature there and get it back into that ancient ERP system. So, and those are massive projects, like up to 600 users who are using it on a daily basis. And that's really where Mendix comes in.
So that's kind of a mission critical application for you then, if I hear the description of it, am I right? Or?
Yeah, unfortunately, yes. In the sense, if it doesn't work, we have a big problem as ICT. And there we are really happy with the fact that it's very reliable, and even if there are fixes, because in the end it's ICT, so yeah, Things break down, because of the low code nature of Mendix, it is easy to apply fixes and therefore be able again as ICT to make sure that the operators can continue their job.
Nice. And I assume those operators are working in a remote setting sometimes without connectivity to the network and so on. Have you made an offline application for that? Or?
The application I'm talking about exactly is offline.
Okay.
So it was a requirement to have that in place.
Yeah. And how do you see this fitting in your larger landscape? Because there's more that you've done in the meanwhile. You've built a kind of portfolio of applications on the platform. What's your kind of strategy? How do you make decisions like this project is low code, this project is maybe more traditional, or this project is maybe another flavor of low code that you have around these days as well? Can you elaborate on that?
The very important part is that we don't want to touch the ERP system. So no customization on the ERP system.
Yeah.
So anytime something that looks like a customization on the ERP system, we think, can't we do that in the front end? Can't we do that maybe in a data warehouse? But quite often it will be in a Mendix application. So then we say, okay, we develop most of the functionality in the front end to make sure that the back end stays stable. So that's a very important decision factor.
And multiple low-code flavors, because there's actually also successful SaaS products around these days that have their low-code offering. You got Office productivity tools with their low-code offering. There's predictions like larger enterprises will then end up with 4 or 5 different flavors of low-code. Are you seeing that in your organization, and are you making kind of conscious decisions as to what workload to put where?
Yes, a little bit. You have to remember we are lean and mean as an IT yeah. department in Mammoet, so we don't want to support five different low-code platforms. But in the end, of course, there's Microsoft Power Apps. It's quite obvious for the simple tasks that we have in the daily office life. Mm. But as soon as we have a massive SAP interface, which is one of the reasons why we selected Mendix, it's their perfect integration into the SAP landscape.
Yeah, got it.
So as soon as we get that, or if we want to integrate multiple platforms like our CRM system, for example, which is Microsoft Dynamics, or yeah. we want to touch the data warehouse, then indeed we start looking at Mendix applications.
Okay, yeah. Interesting.
Yeah.
In terms of where you see low code growing, you mentioned IoT as a use case. Have you actually taken that into production, or is it still kind of an exploratory phase for you?
We are getting very close to making it possible for our business colleagues to actually use it. At this moment, we have several proof of concepts allowing our business colleagues to see wind speeds, for example, which is important in heavy lifting.
Absolutely.
Vertical industry, and then also CO2 emission. I mean, the world is changing, and we for sure know this also. And we are very lucky to have invested like a few years back in Mendix in setting up IoT platforms that now enable us to actually see the actual emission of our equipment. So there, things are moving rapidly.
Yeah. Great. So it's not just cost savings as we are seeing on the slide with reduction of operational cost and also the productivity, but also really innovation that you're driving as an organization.
Yeah, very true. And maybe something that doesn't speak from the numbers is the fact that you can actually make people happy, and that as an ICT department is very important. We are always seen as the black box. Things are happening there. We are really lucky to have Mendix enabling us to deliver and actually surprise people. That is honestly true. By sitting together with them, having a few sessions, develop something within a few days, and then really make a difference in their daily work.
Yeah. That must be very rewarding.
Yeah, it truly is. I mean, that's in the end why you're in there.
Absolutely.
As ICT department, you want to help people. I mean, we're a service department.
Yeah.
And being able to surprise people is just honestly great.
Great. If anyone is watching and would like to kind of explore or start with low code, what would be your kind of recommendation in terms of do's and don'ts for anyone just about to start?
I think you just have to start doing it, but start small.
Yeah.
Just make some low-hanging fruit cases. That you can demonstrate quite quickly to your board. Look, this is what we built last week. This is actually the kind of functionality that we can offer to the floor, to the shop. Is this something that we can use? We can build this and make it bigger and bigger. But as you can see already from this case, this is very easy to develop. So convince them by showing them, maybe even have them participate in a few workshops, see how quickly it evolves if you do a few scrums or something like that.
Nice. Any kind of last remark from your side, John?
Engagement.
Yeah.
It's like what Gerrit is saying. It's very important to show what you're capable of, what the limitations are also. I mean, in the end, there are limitations on ICT development, and you have to engage them in what do you need to do and what is the expectation that you have. And you must have a common ground there, and from there, indeed, take it step by step and grow.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing your story with us. And
okay.
For those of you who are watching, thanks for being with us. And make sure you check out other customer use cases at Mendix World. Thank you.